All right, here we are for round three. We get to go first. Yeah, this hand looks fine. Vessel into Tarmogoyf is actually pretty nice. That should make our Tarmogoyf reasonably big. Psychic Spiral is kind of a dud in this hand, but that's okay. Might end up being good, you never know. Mog Fanatic. Well, it's not going to stop me from playing a Tarmogoyf. Tarmogoyf will be an 0-1, but Mog Fanatic can't kill it because then it becomes a 1-2. So that's fine. However, it cannot block Mog Fanatic, that's for sure. Okay. Now all of the creatures are Mog Fanatics. All right, let's go ahead and just pop Vessel now. See if we can find a green land. Some of ours come into play tapped, so that's why I want to do it now. Think we just want to take Tranquil Thicket here, because that lets us cast Vengevine and whatnot. And doesn't cost us any life. Sure, I'll do that. Play that and attack for four. Not a bad little vessel there. Hit four, three different types. That's about as good as it gets. Yeah, this hand is just a beatdown. We have Vengevine next turn, Deranged Hermit the turn after that, and potentially even Ormondal, depending on what our opponent's life total is looking like. Comes the Mog Fanatic. Oh my. Eternal Witness is also a very nice card for us to pick up if we need that. We can get back like Venser or Mortar Pod. We're really just doing it though. Goblin Bombardment looks like the kind of card that would be pretty good against us, unfortunately. Flametongue Kavu, how rude. Okay, so he's going after Tarmogoyf. That's fine. Then he can trade Vengevine for it, but we still have Deranged Hermit coming up next, so that's okay. Do we want to trade? I think we do. I think it's fine too. We could actually witness back Tarmogoyf also next turn. So yeah, we'll attack here, trade, and then next play Deranged Hermit. And then depending on what they do on their turn, we can just go witness we can not pay Echo, witness back Tarmogoyf and play Tarmogoyf, which will trigger the Vengevine. Alternately, we can just pay Echo and try to win the game that way. But if our opponent plays any creature, then they can Goblin Bombardment our Deranged Hermit, so that's not so great. Okay. A hermit of their own. Interesting. Yeah, I don't really want to pay Echo because they can just shoot their hermit at our hermit, which is not great. Oh my goodness, that is so good. So I guess we just attack with everyone. See how they want to block. Because we don't want to actually get blown out by Goblin Bombardment, which they can do at any time. So this is actually it just isn't that good. There's no way that we can do what we really would want to do here, which is obviously make all of our squirrels live. Because they can just sack Deranged Hermit at any point to ping a squirrel, and then sack all their squirrels to ping our other squirrels. So it's yeah, there's actually just no way to make this good. That's too bad. I think we still just want to witness back Goyf and play it. Seems like a good use of our mana, gets our Vengevine back. Does let Deranged Hermit ping off Eternal Witness, which is too bad. But they still need another way to make a bunch of creatures. Yeah, I was thinking that that was going to actually just go better, but there's no way to make it work the way that I wanted it to work, unfortunately. But we did enough anyway with our very early high pressure plan. So, sideboarding against the red green token deck. Goblin Bombardment is a really good card. I think my early impression of this cube has Goblin Bombardment as one of the best possible cards. That may change later. What do we want? I'm not sure how good the Psychic Spiral plan is against stuff like Goblin Bombardment. Maybe I'll board that out and be on a Beastmaster Ascension plan instead. This card could also be okay. I'm kind of lukewarm on it though. Yeah, I think that's the only change I'm gonna make. We'll just run it like this, hope for the best. All right, here we are for game two. We're on the draw, and this hand is not going to do it. All right, this hand might do it. Cryptolithrite. We have Aether Mutation. Yeah, I think we have enough ways to spend mana with this hand that I'm happy to have Cryptolithrite. It's close. I think because we have Citizen Tactics, we will be able to spend a big pile of mana. So that is enough reason for me to keep it. Okay, don't mind drawing that. Okay, well, Fauna Shaman can deal with that for the time being. Go ahead and play Cryptorite and Mossward Bridge. Let's put Garrick under there because we can tutor for Duskwatch Recruiter perhaps if we need to. This thing gets out of hand if you don't have ways to block it, but for now we have blockers, so it shouldn't be too problematic. If this is like a Murderous Redcap or something, then we might be in trouble. Oh no, that's much worse than Murderous Redcap for us. Well, nothing we can do about it. Okay, I guess we'll go ahead and witness back our guy. Hopefully our opponent casts some big thing that we can Aether Mutation. That's what I would really like to do. Don't know what this is going to be. Wild Beastmaster. Okay. Yeah, we can Aether Mutation that, I guess. 3/1/1s is not bad, and then we can try and get a Citizen Tactics turn off with that. These Death Touch Wolves are going to be pretty annoying, though, I think. Ooh, okay, well, let's see. They have ways to pump up. Yeah, I think just playing the Deranged Hermit is okay. And then we can upkeep cast Garrick Relentless off of it too, which is pretty nice. Blow up some stuff. Definitely not attacking here. Okay, I mean, the right was going to be good, but not that important for our game plan here, I think. That's problematic. I want to block as little as possible because I want to leave Citizen Tactics as a good card for us to draw. So if we. These are all going to be fours, so we can take 16 theoretically. Probably don't want to take quite that much. We'll definitely trade for the Beastmaster. Although if we trade for anything, then we don't get to use Citizen Tactics, or we don't get to cast Garrick, rather. If we just trade for the Beastmaster and block a token, then we can tactics during our upkeep and kill just about everything. Oh, this is bad. Oh, I guess now if we tactics for three during our upkeep, then we can cast Garrick. So that's not so awful. And we can kill the Death Touch Wolf. And then we only get to hit Garrick for two, though. So maybe we should just going to one with facing down Treetop Village just seems so bad, though. Yeah, I think this has to be our block. It's going to be really tough to win from here, though. Okay, so now we go upkeep, tactics. Oh no, we can't actually do this. What's the play? We can tactics onto everything, kill this. Yeah, I don't think we can win. We should have. I guess if we'd Aether Mutation that Beastmaster, maybe we would have been okay. Gaia's Anthem just got us good. All right, Epic Confrontation is definitely a good card against that stupid Beastmaster, so we probably want it in our deck because we don't have that much removal. I think I'm going to board out Survival. Our opponent has Rexage, which is awkward. I kind of want to board out Beastmaster Ascension also. Although we just have too many good targets, probably. Yeah, I think we do. I don't think we can really afford to cut them all. Does Divert do anything? Not really. We could bring in Force Spike. Yeah, I'm going to try this. Although this actually just can kill the turn we play it. Maybe I should board out one of our weaker ones. No, I think this one is prop. Maybe I'll board out this one. Yeah. All right, I'll give this a try. All right, here we are for game three. We get to go first. If only we had another land. This hand would be so good. Yeah, I think we have to mulligan, unfortunately. All right, this is acceptable, I suppose. Not great. This card, it looked like it was pretty good against what our opponent was doing. And Colonian Tusker is a decent amount of pressure. Okay, yeah, we'll keep. Awkward also that we're going to scry. Well, we might as well put that one on the bottom because we're going to Moss Ward Bridge, so we want more options, I suppose. Let's see what we can do. So Vengevine or Venser? Think we want Venser. Probably. Seems like a more likely card to cause a blowout to me. Okay. Hopefully we can just beat down. Ooh, I like that. All right, let's hit with our Tusker, and where do we put the squirrel nest? I guess on our island is fine. We have two double green cards, so putting it on something else seems awkward. Mana Gorge or Hydra, that is pretty good, I think. But we'll just continue to attack. I guess if we get to flip Beastmaster Ascension, we'll probably just win easily. And we actually aren't too bad at doing so. If there's no Rexages coming down, we'll make a guy. We also have a decent chance of flipping Ormondal too. So yeah, all right. This is going fine. Sure. I would definitely trade this Colonian Tusker for that Hydra. So I'll offer that. I mean, they obviously could have a pump spell of some kind for a green mana, but that's fine. That would probably trade for Colonian Tusker at some point in the game anyway. So I don't mind if that happens. Okay, that's fine also. We just won't play a spell this turn. Okay, well now they have to suicide their goblin, so that's something going in our favor at least. I think we'll just trade. Yeah, that's fine. We do want to have more creatures, but it's okay. To keep the goblins under control, I think it's probably worth it. All right, well, I guess we just pass, eat the goblin. We're getting kind of close to Mosswarp Bridge here. And also kind of close to Beastmaster Ascension. Just worried about that Mana Gorge or Hydra, but we're not in the worst shape ever. Ah, he has a Beastmaster Ascension. Well, we do have Viridian Zealot if that thing ever gets out of control, so there's that. Okay, and now we have Westvale Abbey available to be activated as well if we want. We have 7 power in play. We could also. I guess maybe it's good to just make a thing. Yeah, I think I like this. So this puts us up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 power. This puts us up to 10. Even though we don't really want to rebuy Windswept Heath, getting to cast Venser here while our opponent is kind of mana screwed and hit for a bunch seems really good. And this actually puts us up at 7 creatures, which is the magic number for Beastmaster Ascension on our next turn. Also, we have Westvale Abbey that can flip. We have a lot of ways to win this game now. Assuming they don't have a sweeper, which seems unlikely. It doesn't. Our opponent's deck did not look like a sweeper kind of deck. All right, there we go. A little 3-0. That was pretty fun. I've been enjoying this cube. There's some real power level disparities in the decks sometimes, but it's pretty fun otherwise.